want us to shift the camera here. Well, let's install it. The...
News. Nice to meet you. I see quite a few of your articles. Very nice.
Thank you. Okay.
Of course.
Thanks for coming.
I get a deep later. How is everything done? Okay. Oh, from Nikki. Well, there's Nikki right there. That's yours?
Let's put it on the table. Why is that one they put? That's on the
castle. Oh, because it was too big. She couldn't get the picture.
No, it was too big.
Well, for her camera.
It does not.
Well, you're in charge of the flowers.
Is it possible for you to do that?
Maybe.
Change the...
You could have...
is it possible to do it from that angle? Because you want to have the other okay on there.
Okay.
Okay. Yes, we'll move that.
Say this to your mom.
Thank you.
You have mentioned the
army. Yes, yeah, talk about you. No, not that. No, it's just me.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, I saw him there, right?
Oh, I don't have it. I don't know.
Okay. Okay.
I need to find my. Thank you. to another, you know, whenever I reach into the whole family center, I really miss it.
Thank you. My dear friends, good afternoon. I am on time by my watch. And I am ready to prepare for class 3 from that was somewhere I have seen. So my apologies for the longer to make a sacrifice as we prepare for inclement weather. In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit, the grace and peace of God, our Father, and our Lord Jesus Christ, be with all of you. I bless the body of John Francis Wilbert Casimir. I bless the body of Francis Rupert Casimir. With the holy water, who recalls his baptism, of which St. Paul writes, all of us who are baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death. By baptism into his death, we were together with him. So just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him by likeness to his death, so shall we be united with him by likeness to his resurrection. On the day of his baptism, Robert put on Christ. In the day of Christ's coming, may be clothed with glory. Entrance. Once again, my apologies for coming a little late.
every thought we will on behalf of us. May I sacrifice for our country and for our believing people and for my family. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, all faithful blessings that are so night and rose again, mercifully grant that through this ministry, your servant who but was fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice twice again through him, ways and ways with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever.
Tears from every cheek. He will take away his people's shame everywhere on earth. For the Lord has said so. That day it will be said, see, this is our God, in whom we hope for salvation. The Lord is the one in whom we hope. We exult and we rejoice that he has saved us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. With God on our side, who can be against us? Since God did not spare his own Son, but gave him up to benefit us all, we may be certain, after such a gift, that he will not refuse anything he can give. Could anyone accuse those that God has chosen? When God acquits, could anyone condemn? Could Christ Jesus? No. He not only died for us, he rose from the dead, and there at God's right hand, he stands and pleads for us. Nothing, therefore, can come between us and the love of Christ. Even if we are troubled or worried, or being persecuted or lacking food or clothes, or being threatened or even attacked, these are the trials through which we triumph by the power of him who loved us. For I am certain of this, neither death, nor life, nor angel, no prince, nothing that exists, nothing still to come, not any power or height or depth, nor any created thing can ever come between us and the love of God made visible in Christ Jesus our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Eat my flesh and drink my blood has eternal life,
and I shall raise him up on the last day. For my flesh is good food, and my blood is real drink. He who eats my flesh and drinks my blood lives in me, and I live in him. As I, who am sent by the living Father, myself draw life from the Father, so whoever eats me will draw life from me. This is the bread come down from heaven, not like the bread your ancestors ate. They are dead, but anyone who eats this bread will live forever. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
After having given me, us, an account of his formal encounter with his wife, Mother Dorothy, the famous Pinch. I talk about this afterwards. Every time I went to visit the home, I delighted in pinching her. Not wickedly, just an amicable way of greeting her. And she smiled. She smiled. The inaugural pinch brought another reaction. My dear friends, so often when we think of national icons, we make reference to certain individuals who feature in the world of sports and become termed patriots. But the exemplary life of my dear friend, Mr. Casimir, has brought us here in this hot time of year. And this is real life, and for all the accolades received, do qualify him as a national icon. We're not going to allude to sports, although he was involved in cricket, weightlifting, boxing, and went on to practice yoga. Being an intellectual luminary, I call him Rupert, never call him Rupert. He especially in the world of statistics, he made his mark here and beyond the region because of his ambition, determination, and perseverance, which caused him to earn top positions in Dominica and further afield. It would be remiss of me if I did not make reference to the eulogy, in which what I just said is corroborated. He was really a well-rounded man, a handsome man at that. He was born handsome, he lived handsomely, he died a handsome man. And proud of his death, he began to wear a nice gray beard, qualifying him as a patriarch. This is a man who was always beautifully attired. No wonder he and Mother could not resist each other, because of a strange event which Miriam defined as sweet pain. Not a clout, not a slap, but a whack, says Miriam. A whack from Dorothy, a pinch from Daddy, then the tears from Dorothy's eyes shook Daddy's heart, causing more palpitations to take place, without any fear of any cardiac arrest or disorder. The mummy is beautiful with dark eyes and spoke volumes. And Daddy capitulated to the light of mother, who said to herself, I've caught, not attitude, but a baleen, a whale, a big fish. Lovers and couples in the making, perhaps you can emulate with the cat's name and his wife. By practicing this formula, whack, pinch, tears, proposal, yes, we care. In fact, before I commence mass, I did go long to the Dorothy and pitched both arms, and she was delighted. Yes, it was in 1946 that my brother friend met the love of his life, Dorothy Hughes. I never knew. Many will know the story of the slap and the pinch, which was repeated all the time. You know, in this day and age when people will last forever, even as platonic friends. These people married 73 years. They had 8 children, one of whom was sadly a stillbirth. But Rupert and Dorothy were blessed with a long-lasting love, soulmates who nurtured each other, a devoted, warm, and loving couple whose lives remained entwined and would hold hands even in the last days together. May I continue? When I said it was my icon, it's more than my icon. As a young man, Robert was ambitious and applied himself conscientiously to acquiring the knowledge and skills he needed to further his education and career. It was thus he rose from a job as a junior clerk in Dominica's civil service for an appointment as statistician in 1960 in the short-lived federal government. This led to his acquiring a post in 1963 with the United Nations in those days. Initially, Addis Ababa, Ethiopia, with the Economic Commission for Africa. His employment involved visiting many countries in Africa to give expert advice to governments on statistical practice. Moving on. Highly intellectual, highly educated, yet so very reserved, so very humble. Eventually, he went on to become chief of the International Trade Classification and Analysis Section at the UN headquarters in New York. And then realized anew that this man spoke French and could communicate in both Italian and Aramaic. I don't know that word. The language was spoken in Ethiopia. An avid reader he was, and a very fluent Catholic. Very fluent Catholic. As a devout Catholic, he was a deeply religious and prayerful man, whose faith was reflected in every aspect of his life. He had a special devotion to Our Lady, encouraging his young children to pray the rosary as a family evening prayer, and his daughters to join Little Mary. He believed in helping those less fortunate, and generously was there for others. In retirement, he was involved in setting up a retirement home for the elderly in Dominica.
He also gave a great deal of time to running the Voice of Islands radio station. So, my dear friends, all the three names proclaimed to be remind us of a daddy. Before you wipe this door, have a drink. On this mountain, a banquet, a feast. This is a man who worked hard, but enjoyed life since he practiced hospitality. And he injected these values in his family. In today's second reading, Paul says that the God did not hesitate to put everything in line for us. Mr. Rupert Casney did not hesitate to put everything in line for his family. A dear father, a dear husband, a dear friend, a dear citizen of his country. He made time for his friends because he was a people's person and was committed to helping people. Today's gospel would point us to Christ, the bread of life, most likely touched his life. He loved his church. He loved the people. He loved the mass. No wonder he reminded me of his intention to become a priest many years ago. But when he set eyes on Dorothy and saw these shining eyes, he accepted the whack, pinched, allowed himself to be anointed by the tears of Mother Dorothy. There was no turning back, and he boasted of the wife. A devout Catholic who gave him such support for his life. The tents which shaped the life of my friend, Sir Rupert, were his firm beliefs in the values of honesty, loyalty, and service. We thank you for your prayerful support. And we praise the deceased for his joie de vivre, his equality of humor, his profound faith in Jesus and the church. We thank the helpers, not helpers, they were family. Up this morning I passed, and I was still asking the lips, are you ready for the mix? That's all right. When you come and get a bit, always there to help. Shrined because of the hospitality of this family. So I salute you, Mr. Casney, faithful husband, genuine friend, and amazing citizen. We can say that he's not a man who walked about the world with his hand, nor a Bible, who didn't talk the scriptures, but he acted the scriptures. A religious man who made time for his family, friends, and the destitute. We can say that he performed every task with the idea of advancing himself, not selfishly. He held to his faith and purpose to increase his life at all times. Like all of us, most of us in mediation, he tried, he succeeded. Since he has left us a wonderful legacy, all of us, his children, family, and friends. I thank the Lord for him, For allowing me to be part of the family. For allowing me to welcome and welcome the family. I thank the Lord for His services to the church, especially the voice of the islands. Do pray for me as I do for you. Amen. Could you please stand? Good people of the Lord, be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ, His Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask Him to save His people, living and dead.
Lord, you wept at the death of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in your sorrow. We ask this in faith.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
Raise the dead to life. Give Rupert eternal life. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
You promised paradise to the thief who repented. Bring Rupert to the joys of heaven. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Rupert was washed clean in baptism and anointed with the oil of salvation. Give him fellowship with all your saints. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Rupert was nourished with your body and blood. Grant him a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Comfort us in our sorrow at the death of our Rupert. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer. And of course, it could be very, very hot. There's a heat wave going all the way down to September, and we are preparing for this strange, inclement weather. God's will be done. We pray the Lord to protect us from storms and other disasters. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We also hear that former priest not very, very well. Father Charles Martin is at home taking chemotherapy. Father Laffey is trying to send him away. Father Frank McCarthy is in New York. He went through some tests. And Father Joe. And Joseph was here, he has been on chemotherapy. And we pray for all the priests who walk around who don't feel well themselves. We pray for the healing. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
I pray for you. Do the same things on my behalf. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray. Lord, hear our prayers for dead brothers and sisters. Forgive them all the sins and bring them to the fullness of your salvation. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our Lady of Fair Haven,
pray for us.
Jesus, meek and humble of heart,
meek of all hearts, I come to thine.
Thank you.
That my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice from your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for all good and the better of His holy Church.
With your Lord, we pray to your servant Rupert, on whose funeral day we offer you this sacrifice of conciliation. So that through any sin of sin and come to her, to him, or any human fault of affected him, he may by your loving gift be forgiven and wiped away through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord be with you. Saddened by the certainty of dying, might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when the earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
fully, therefore, these gifts we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord.
And let the rest of the light shine upon them.
May you rest in peace.
Amen.
May the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
Remember also, brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of the face. Have mercy on each one of us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, her spouse Joseph, with the rest of the apostles, and all the saints who are pleased throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus the Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to stand.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who call to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you enter upon the roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. servant, my friend Rupert, who was journeying from this world, may by his sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord. Many friends, or dear brother, husband, parishioner, friend, has gone to this rest in the peace of Christ. With faith and hope in eternal life, let us commend him to the loving mercy of our Father and assist him with all prayers. He became God's Son through baptism and was often fed at the table of our Lord Jesus Christ. May the Lord Lord welcome him to the table of God's children in heaven, and for all the saints may he inherit eternal life. Let us also pray to the Lord for ourselves. May we mourn, be reunited one day with them. Together may we meet Christ Jesus, when he, who is our life, shall appear in his glory. I know that my
I Thank you. On behalf of AMO News and Team AMO News, we would like to thank everyone for tuning in for the celebration of the life of John Francis Rupert Kazimi. We would also want to welcome everyone to the burial service, which will be broadcast live shortly. Please bear with us as we make our way to the burial site.
Thank you.
at home now.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, by the 3 days
of
you made holy the grace of all who believe in you, and even though the bodies lie in the earth, the trust that they like you will rise again, give our friend and brother, husband, peace to rest in this grave, until that day when you, the resurrection and life, will raise him up in glory. The beast, light of your presence, Lord Jesus, in the kingdom, may you live and reign once God forever. Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Since Almighty God has called our brother Rupert from this life to himself, becoming his body to the earth from which he was made, Christ was the first to rise from the dead, and we know that he will raise up our mortal bodies to be like his in glory. And so we commend our friend to the Lord. The Lord will receive him in his praise and peace and raise him up on the last day. Lord Jesus Christ, by the 3 days you lay in the tomb, you made holy the grace of all who believe in you, and even though the body's life in the earth, the trust that they will like to rise again, leave our brother to rest in his grave until that day when you the resurrection and the life. Raise him up in glory. Then may he see the light of your presence, Lord Jesus, in the kingdom where you live forever and ever. First, before brother, to the Lord Jesus Christ, he said, I am the resurrection and the life. The man who believes in me will live if he dies, and every living person who puts his faith in me will never suffer eternal death. Lord, you went to the death of Lazarus, your friend, fellowship of all your sins. Lord, hear us. He was nourished with your body and blood. Grant him a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom. Lord, hear us. And the dinner of the cathedral, Father Nigel asked me to extend his condolences to all of you. And I will see him once again. Comfort us in our soul at the death of our brother Rupert. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. Lord, hear us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. Let us pray. Almighty God, through the death of your Son on the cross, you have overcome death for us. Through his burial and resurrection from the dead, you gain the great holy place and restore to us eternal life. Equip those who died within Jesus Christ and the third is given the hope of life again. Those who faithfully believe in you friend. Really big, really flattering. Go to this place. We're doing unholy companions. Forgive all brother and sister. We open the gates of life for those who believe in you. But let our brother depart from you. But by your glorious power, giving light, joy, and peace in heaven, where you labor and reign, one God forever and ever. Amen. To the rest of land unto him, O Lord. May he rest in peace, for his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, for the mercy of God, rest in peace. May friends, remember, you are just, on dust shall return.
It is well, it is well. the worlds thy hands have made. I see the sun, I hear the rolling thunder, and all around the universe is there. Then sings the song, my Savior and its glory. How is the world? How is the world? Then sings my song, my Savior and its glory. How is the world?
Thank you. All I ask of you is forever to remain. All my life you have been faithful. know you are the friend I have lived in the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so strong.
Thank you.
I have them already.
She has the card.
Oh, she took them away.
This live was brought to you once again by Emo News and Team Emo News. We'd want to thank everyone for joining today, and we'd also like to take this time to convey our heartfelt sympathies to John Francis Rupert Kazimi, family and friends. During this difficult time, we hope you may find comfort, strength, and courage in God. Family would like to thank everyone who helped support our father. We would like to thank all the friends who have helped by visiting our parents and in any way that they could.